Yeah, so basically, anyway, that's what I'm gonna wear. So we've got that resolved quick and fast. I'm gonna get the stylist to steam it, and that should be it. Whose bag's this? Yours, Frogs?
Yeah, that's mine.
That's a hard bag, you know. I knew it had to be yours. Yeah, that bag's hard, fucking hell. It's me, your boy, Pot of Paper, here with my fucking old school friend Rashid at Link Up TV, here at my London show, Roundhouse. Second night, second sold out night, do you know what I mean? So we're all right, alhamdulillah. My rider, broski, my rider is confirmed. Have to have this. If it's not there, I'm kicking up a fuss. My water has to be the diesel water, straight from the mountains of Albania. pH level very high, alkaline, all these things. If you know what's going on, then you know. Same for this Manuka honey. Have Manuka honey for your throat. You know what I'm saying, to help you out. It's very good for your health anyway, very big health benefits. Some candles, usually I'll have the lights dim in it because I don't like it to be too bright. So I've got some candles going anyway, that's a fire hazard. Some cream your face and that. If you know about fragrances and you know about this, it's a serious fragrance, bro. I'll just spray it so you can confirm it for them, Rush.
Confirmed.
So there you go, that's a grown man's fragrance. Then we've got some fruit there, but obviously we've got ginger, lemon. That also can be added with that for a mad combination. And make a nice tea with that. This is the Henny, but obviously there are many, many other alcohol brands out there and available, do you know what I'm saying? I'm just out there. Oh, gotta big up the Magnums, a nice empty. Someone's done it, not me though, I actually ain't drunk it. I don't really drink before my shows and shit, but I smoke cigarettes. This here, brother, is my jewellery box that was made for me by The Secret Garden. To be honest, I travel light, innit? I just put a couple bits in what I'm gonna be wearing. Okay, so basically, this is the space where I keep my watches, but today I've only brought out these watches today. This is called the John Mayer. This is a big boy kettle. Got this from The Secret Garden, my boy Danny the Jeweler. I believe this is discontinued, and I got it for good piece because I bought it when the times was right. You know what I mean? I feel like this is quite sophisticated, goes with anything. And like, if you know about watches and you see this, you're gonna know, or you're gonna think that I know about watches. And then this is a Patek Philippe. Bust down, you know what I'm saying? Mad one, can't lie to you. This one set me back an arm and a leg. With this, if you see me with this, you'll start, if you know about watches and you know about money and this stuff, you start like trying to give me lessons on finance and that, like, oh, shouldn't bust down your watches, man. La, la, la. By the end of the day, we're just having fun, bro. Alhamdulillah, innit? We never had nothing. At the time, Rashid, remember me, bro? I didn't have jack shit, bro. You know what I mean? So, oh yeah, this is my championship ring for training day 3. So it's got a pot of paper, then it's got the TD3 there, then it's got the date when it came out, got the blocks there, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, man, that's what we're doing it, alhamdulillah. But all my jewelry just comes from one guy though, Secret Garden, Danny the Jeweler. Take a look in this box, look, when you take the watch thing out, look at the embroidery and that.
Detailed, isn't it?
Bro, trust me, the finer things. Right. Oh yeah, sir, and I didn't show you that this comes out, and then these are the place for my chains, innit? That's the old school pinky goes there. Legendary pink note. And then this is for this part of paper thing, you know what I'm saying? They know that I like to smoke, innit? I'm a big advocate for the cannabis culture, innit? You know what I'm saying? So with that, they just thought it would be funny, like, and a little bit whatever to put a grander in there and a bit of scales, whatever, funny guys, innit? Big up my boys, man. It's the small things in life that really mean a lot though, innit? Do you know what I mean? It's thoughtful. That cake was a gift from my team. And this balloons, it says 3-6. The balloons. My team got me this. They got me this. To you, Mr. PP, we are so proud of you and everything you've achieved. Love 3-6 the label.
Priceless.
Familiar, bro. Do you know what I'm saying? That's real love. Then here, we got a cookie. Mad cookie. So we're gonna give this to the brothers anyway to eat. It's Ramadan. So we're gonna take that out there soon, just pass that about. Make sure everyone gets a piece and that. And yeah, we're just here. Yeah, Space Raider, that's the old school crisp, you know what I'm saying? I actually went and bought that with my hard-earned money. They did not give it to us. Maybe they would one day. But yeah, so put in your comments anyway. Yeah, if this is gonna get clipped, put in the comments. What's your favorite Space Raider? What one are you gonna go for?
What's your one?
The one at the back.
What, this your? This
the best one.
No, what, this your one, yeah?
It's your one.
These ones, no, I used to slap these ones in the can. I used to eat 10 of them. So yeah, anyway, just let us know. And Space Raiders, cut us a check.
Man, what's the pre-show ritual, man, before you get on stage? Anything you gotta do?
You know what it is? My pre-show ritual is I just make sure that I get a moment to myself. whether it's in a toilet, whether it's just over in a corner, whether I just zone out with my in-ears in. But I just take a moment to myself. I say a prayer, but not a conventional prayer. I just say Surah Al-Fatiha. If anyone knows who that is, they'll know what that is. And I just say that in my head. And then I just get out there, mate, and rock the stage, as you're gonna see tonight. You know, it's like, see, like rapping for me is second nature. So like, I rapped everywhere. I rapped like on the playground in secondary school. I rapped on the blocks. I rapped in the car. I rapped in the court cell out my door. I rapped on the exercise yard. I rapped in the seg out the window. I rapped everywhere you can think of. I rapped. So this is one of the best places I've ever rapped, at the Roundhouse, in front of people that have changed my life and continue to change my life. So I'm forever humbled, bro, at the end of the day. Like, the ritual is just like being humbled by the whole experience.
I remember you were changing
people's
lives too,
my guy. Alhamdulillah. See, you know, what's his name? Khabib. I mean, not me, him. It's not me, bro. It's God, innit? You know what I'm saying?
And what keeps you motivated anyway?
The legacy, bro. The legacy of it all. Just like the fact of what this has all turned into, and then the fact that now, like, at first we weren't rappers, then we was rappers, then we became like better men. Now we're more than rappers, now we're entrepreneurs, you know, and assets to this industry. And we just keep growing and just keep pushing, like, for everyone, innit? You know what I'm saying? It's not for me, as you can see with the label, with everything else that we're doing. But a paper is just one part of that, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, bro.
Say, well, I'll leave you to it, my guy.
Respect, cuzzy. Thank you, bro.